Everybody, I hope you are all doing great today. I am Rekha Diyar. I am a developer advocate at SAP Developer Advocacy and Community Relations team. Today, I have Gopal Anand along with me to discuss about a very important topic, BTP Developer's Guide. So it's an immense pleasure to host you, Gopal Anand. So Gopal Anand is a product expert on SAP BTP, and he's passionate on SAP technologies. So I welcome you to this code talk.
Yeah, thank you so much, Rekha.
Yeah. So over to you, Gopal. So you can just briefly introduce about yourself, and then we can jump into the topic.
Yeah. So hi, everyone. Glad to meet you all. I am Gopal, and I'm part of the BTP team where we are currently working on the BTP Developer's Guide. And I have been working as a BTP product expert here and trying to bring out some of the best practices to you so that when you are building the applications, you get the best out of the SAP infrastructure. You have to use all these frameworks. We recommend what is the best things from the developer's guide, but it's again open-ended, and it helps you throughout the development lifecycle, where you start with the development of the application, how do you deliver the application, as well as how, at the end, how do you integrate the different business processes with it. So yeah, that's about me.
Okay, good. Thank you for the introduction. Put it in a nutshell, like how do you describe the BTP Developer's Guide? Why we have to refer to the BTP Developer's Guide?
That's a great question, because you know, when we refer to the open source community or with the SAP infra, we have like so many help documentation spread across different sites, right? And if I have to build something, there's no single point where you go and you basically get started with. So with the developer guide, we try to bring some building blocks, which helps you deliver the application, build the application from scratch. So you can be a beginner who is just starting with, let's say, the SAP tools or terminologies. It can be BTP itself, or the CAP framework, or the ABAP. So you just see like what are the base on which I can build up the application. Now, while building the application, again, there are so many services available on BTP. So the question comes that, okay, what services are supposed to be used for these use cases? So we talk about what are the services that are getting used here. Then comes the product standards. Now, again, when you are building a business application, you need to follow a lot of product standards. It could be GDPR or security, authentication, authorization, and so on. So what provides you all these things? So we come up with this building block. So first block is basically, we can say, development. So what are the things needed there? It could be building the UI, then adding different services, how to integrate the services. Once you have the application ready during the development phase, you deliver. So how do you deliver? We use the CI/CD, the continuous integration and delivery. So again, some services offered from BTP, which helps you for this process. And at the end, how do you integrate the different remote system? It could be S/4HANA cloud or on-premise systems. So how do you integrate your application to the system so you can read, write data? So we have this blueprints curated for you, where you can just go step by step, learn each of the things from the basics, and you follow a standard offered from SAP so that when you are scaling up your application, you don't get stuck. You have the best practices followed, so you are basically worry free that your application can face a roadblock in the long run. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you for the answer. So I would like to know, like, how the developer guide is structured. What are the key topics that are covered, and how they are organized in the developer guide?
So in the developer guide, we have two versions. One is the ABAP cloud one. So that's available on the help.sap.com, and it is linked with multiple tutorials, which you can follow to learn about ABAP cloud. We also have the guide on the cloud application programming model, which is the CAP-based developer guide. Now, this guide starts with what's the need of the developer guide for you, why it's needed, what are the different building blocks of this developer guide. Then it gets started with different sections. First, a develop section, where you start by initializing the project, bootstrapping the project with the CDS init or command. You choose the tool or the framework where you want to develop. It could be Business Application Studio or VS Code. Now, once you have the development environment and initiated the project, you start with modeling the data. So we talk about how data modeling takes place. After you model your data, we try to show you how to expose this data as a service or data service. Then we talk about how do you add custom logic, followed by how do you add the UI. Again, Fury Elements by CUI, where you use the productivity tools or Fury tools to model your front end for the end users. After your UI is ready, you also add authentication authorization, which is again very critical for the business application. So once again, the authentication authorization, the app is ready. For a developer, it's also very critical that you add the test cases, right? So your change in the logic doesn't break the application. So we talk about how do you write the test cases? What are the framework or the best practices when you are writing the test cases for your business logic? So once you have the test cases, then we talk about how you do you bundle the application and make it available for the production environment. How do you deploy it to the Kima runtime or the Cloud Foundry runtime based on your requirements as your business will be having. So once you have the deployment ready, you can deploy directly or you can configure the CI/CD tools, which basically periodically deploys the application. So if you make changes in the application, you run the test cases, validate everything. Then your CI/CD triggers, and then it will deploy the application to the BTP, to the runtime of your choice. So that's how the whole structure is. So once you have the beginner or the basic tutorial completed, we also have some additional tutorials. So those things basically talk about how to connect to the remote systems. It could be S4HANA. So normally it's the REST-based API where you read some data, how do you configure this data between BTP and S4, how do you read write those data, how do you configure the destinations, then consuming that in CAP application, doing some logic so you read that data, customize something there. So once you have a remote service, we again talk about chain tracking, audit logging, which are in terms of business standards. These are some of the things you need to have in the application as part of the GDPR, all the product standards we talk about. So yeah, that's how the whole structure is. We have the beginner guide where we talk like from scratch, a beginner, how they can build application. Then we have something which is where you have additional things for integration or the product standards use cases. So that's what is there currently. And we are also working step by step currently on this developer guide to add more services and more additional tutorials where you can see the different product standards meeting or the more complex use cases getting into the picture. So right now it's with the remote service with the eventing as such, because event-based architecture is a recommendation from SAP because it's very efficient in terms of data read and write. So that's what the structure is. Yeah.
Oh, wow. This is really nice to hear. It's very well structured right from the BTP setup till the end of the application development and delivery. All the aspects of software development lifecycle is covered, and the developer can reference to this developer guide at every stage of the application development. This is a good thing to hear. And also, I believe it's a living document and it will be updated as and when there is a new feature or new advancements happens on BTP, right?
Yep. It's evolving. It's evolving and it's evolving with the best things that we have. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Thanks for the answer. And have you been using this guide personally in your day-to-day work to develop some applications, either for the customer or it could be for demo purposes? Are you using it and how it is helping you personally? We would like to know.
You know, it's actually very helpful because there are days where you have to build a quick demo. Now, how do you make it? At times, what I personally do is like just clone the repository which is there, make some changes, and my app is ready already. But if I'm getting stuck, let's say I want to have some custom logic in CAP, and how do I do it? So I can just quickly refer to the BTP developer guide custom logic section and see how CAP, where I the logic is as in, how do you add logic or handlers in CAP to read, write, or customize something? Now, let's say I wanted to connect to remote system. So normally the steps are too, you know, cumbersome. Like you need to follow a lot of things when you are connecting or setting up the destination. So that's where I very often, when I have to configure the remote systems to my demo use cases or connect to S4, I just refer to a developer guide to just follow the steps, because for the use cases, maybe the APIs I need from S4 might be different, but overall the basic steps are the same. So instead of me getting confused somewhere and missing a step, which will take a lot of time to debug, that's where we all developers struggle a lot. I have something to refer to, and then basically I will be reading it again, and then, okay, these are the basic steps, one by other. I will just follow the steps, just change the things needed as per my use case, and ta-da, my app is ready. So I think I am one of the biggest consumer of the developer guide myself.
Good to hear about that. We are using our own product and it is helping us in day-to-day life. If we have to contribute to the developer guide as developers, is there any public repository where we can submit our changes or anything like that?
So we have a GitHub repository where the developer guides, the basic application is. Also, the help.sap.com, if you search on Google, like BTP developer guide, you land on that page where we have written, like, if you want to contribute, how you can contribute here. So you can just refer there and see if you can contribute, or you can also, let's say, comment there saying you require some more information on certain things, and maybe in the future iteration we can consider adding it also as part of the developer guide. So you can contribute as part of the help documentation, the help.sap.com.
Okay, this is great, and it's good to know that developer guide is going to improve the developer efficiency, at the same time improving the developer experience while doing development on the BTP. Thank you very much for all the answers, and I thank you everybody watching this code talk, and please subscribe to our SAP Developers YouTube channel so that you can join a community or ecosystem of SAP developers just like you, and you can share ideas and learn new things. I thank our guest Gopal Anand for sharing his valuable knowledge, and the session was really insightful. I hope to see you next time. Until then, keep learning. Thank you
everyone.